No one imagined that humans could ever hold the power of lightning. But in the 1700s, a glass jar changed everything. With the Leyden jar, we captured electricity, the source of lightning, inside a bottle. Then Franklin flew a kite, pulled lightning from the sky, and trapped it in a Leyden jar. So what did people do first with lightning power? Well, believe it or not, they played shock games. They held hands in a line, then zapped the last person with the Leyden jar. Everyone got shocked, bam, falling on their butts. At first, it was just curiosity.
How many people can this thing shock?
10? 100? 200? They kept breaking records like it was a contest. But then, something weird happened. Joseph Aignan Cigaud de Lafon, a science guy, was doing a shock demo. Out of 60 people, the spark stopped at number 16. No one knew why. Then someone joked,
"Maybe that guy's, you know, missing something down there."
Weirdly, it kind of made sense to them. Those cursed by nature can't carry electricity. The rumor spread fast. Soon, people started treating it like fact. De Lafon wanted to fix the misunderstanding, but he had no way to prove it. People just said,
"If it's not true, just show us. What's the matter? Can't do it."
Then one day he had a brilliant idea. He'd do a shock demo at the royal court. His test subjects, the royal musicians, who were eunuchs. It was his one shot. The charge flowed through all of them. No problem. They even reacted more than usual. Maybe it was just a passionate performance to defend eunuch pride. But modern science says otherwise. The charge likely escaped through wet floors or the kind of shoes they wore. Lies spread fast. But truth always needs proof. The Leyden jar has been showing us that for a long, long time. If we believe in science, maybe it's time we ask lies for proof, too.